come to 3-mark questions. This first question I will discuss. This is a very, very important question. This question is also in your NCERT book. Okay? Just carefully observe, but the data is changed here. A construction worker's helmet slip and fall when he is 78.4 meter above the ground. He hears the sound of the helmet hitting the ground in 4.23 seconds after it slips. Find the speed of the sound in air. So just see, here the helmet, it will reach the ground and strike the ground and hear the echo after 4.23 seconds. It's okay? 4.23 seconds and the height is 78.4 meters. Find the speed of sound in air. So, here you know that when helmet fall down, it will take some time to strike the ground. After that, the sound has to travel this much distance. What time it will take? You have to find the speed of sound, that means velocity of the sound. How much? It's okay. So first find the time, what time it will take by the helmet to strike the ground. That means S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Means U is initially 0 because it is ready to fall. U is 0 plus half A, you have to take G. G means 9.8 because it is in decimal. Okay? If it is a whole number, then you have to take 10. But in the question, it is not given. If in the question, it is not given, you have to take 9.8. If given, you have to take 10. Mainly, the students are getting puzzled. When will take 10? When will take 9.8? In the question, if you have to take 10, it is also given in the question. Otherwise, you have to take 9.8. So, here I will take 9.8 into t square. Is equal to how much? 78.4. So, this is 4.9. t square is equal to 78.4 by 4.9 is equal to 784 by 49. Because this is by 10, this is by 10. Okay? Now, it is, if you cut it directly, it will be 16, or you cut it by 7, it will be 7 and it will be 112. Then again 7 you will cut means it is 16. So what is t? T is equal to square root of 16 is equal to 4 seconds. So time taken by the helmet to strike the ground is 4 seconds. Now how much time it will remain? So 4.23 seconds minus 4 seconds is equal to 0.23 seconds. So, in this time interval, the sound produced here will travel 78.4 meters. Therefore, we are able to hear the sound. Therefore, here it is the time given, it is the distance given. So, speed is equal to distance by time is equal to what is the distance? 78.4 by 0.23 is equal to 7840 by 23. 23 3 is a 69. Then 94, 23, 4, 92, then 20, around 1. Means 349 point something or approximately 341 meter per second. It's okay? Come to next 3-mark question. Define the term tone. Tone means it is the single wave or single disturbance. A person is listening to a sound 500 hertz sitting at a distance 450 meter from the source of sound. What is the time interval between successive compression reaching his ear from the source? That means you have to find the wavelength. First, tone we have discussed. Person listening a sound 500 hertz means frequency is given to you 500 hertz. Sitting at a distance 450 meter. Distance is 450 meter. You have to find what is the time interval between successive compression reaching his ear from the source. That means the time taken for successive compression. Successive compression means wavelength. It is wavelength. So, find the time to complete one oscillation. That means it is time period. So, time period means T is equal to 1 by F. No need of this thing. This is the NCERT question. So, it is equal to 1 by 500. It's okay. Or 2 by 1000 is equal to 0.002 seconds. So, this is the time period. Next question, state a condition for an echo to be heard. That means there must be an obstacle and source of sound. And distance between source of sound and the obstacle is minimum more than 17.2 meters. It's okay? at 25 degree Celsius. If more than 25, then again you have to calculate to by using 2D is equal to VT. So according to this question, we have to write at 25 degree Celsius, it is 17.2 meter. Next bit, bats cannot see, then how they catch its prey? Since bats has no eye, so it cannot see. But through the ear, it can hear the ultrasound or ultrasonic wave. Bats mainly emit the ultrasonic wave. It strikes the prey and returns back. The reflection is received by the bat on its ear and detect at how much distance the prey is present. Like this, it can catch its prey. Another important question I will discuss here. In the given figure or distance time graph for the wave is shown. The wave velocity is 320 meter per second. The wave velocity is 320 meter per second. Then from the graph, find wavelength, frequency and amplitude. So what is the wavelength? Just see here. From here to here, it is 0.4 meter. So lambda is 0.4 meter. So wavelength, what is the amplitude? This length, height of the crest, which is 2 meter. So amplitude is 2 meter. Then the third bit, frequency you have to find. F is equal to how much? F is equal to V by lambda, means V is 320 by lambda is how much? 0.4 meter. So is equal to 3200 by 4 is equal to 800 hertz. This is a very, very important question. You just carefully observe. Next question, the sound of an explosion on the surface of lake is heard by a boatman 100 meter away and the diver 100 meter below the point of explosion. That means on the surface of lake an explosion takes place 100 meter away, a person is there, 100 meter inside the lake, a diver is there. Of the two persons mentioned here, who would hear the sound first and why? Actually, the person inside the water 100 meter, he will hear the sound first because the speed of sound is more in case of water rather than air. In air, it is approximately 340 or 346, but in water, it is 1530 or 1490. 1530 means if it is a salted water. It's okay. Therefore, since the speed of sound in water is maximum as compared to air, therefore the person or the diver inside the water is able to hear the sound very quickly as compared to the person on the surface of lake. Next bit, calculate the wavelength of a sound wave whose frequency is 220 hertz and speed is 440 meter. It is very easy. Frequency is 220 hertz, velocity is 440. Wavelength, V is equal to F lambda, or lambda wavelength is equal to V by F, means 440 by 220. Next 3 mark question, what is audible range of average human ear? It is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Explain how ultrasound is used to clean spiral tubes and electronic components. Ultrasound means it is a high energetic wave. That means more than 20,000 hertz. It is frequency. So when we apply the ultrasound, it vibrates vigorously the components. So easily the dust or the grease particles or oily particles present in it detach from it. So you can wash it easily. Next 3 mark question, why the stage of an auditorium has curved background, contain curtains, carpet and false ceiling? Auditorium has curved background means in any direction you can speak, the total sound gets reflected to the persons. And the ceilings are made up of curtain, sound absorbing material, that means they will absorb the reverberation or multiple reflection takes place inside the room. Its second bit, the sound of a ringing bell inside a vacuum chamber cannot be heard. Why? Because sound wave is a mechanical wave, it always need a material medium to propagate. So in a vacuum no medium is there, therefore sound cannot travel. Next 3 mark question, ocean waves of time period 0.01 second have a speed 15 meter per second. Calculate the wavelength of the wave. Find the distance between adjacent crest and the trough. So time period is 0.01 second. It is given and speed is 15 meter per second. So from the time period, you can easily find the frequency. F is equal to 1 by T means 1 by 0.01. It is 1 by 100. So is equal to 100 hertz. So here V is given, velocity. Here frequency is given. Find the distance between the adjacent crest and trough. Adjacent crest and trough means in a wave, adjacent crest and trough means it is lambda by 2. So first find lambda, then you can easily get lambda by 2. Adjacent crest means it is wavelength lambda. But crest and trough means it is lambda by 2. So here you have to find lambda. Lambda is equal to V by F means 15 by 100. So this is your wavelength. But what is lambda by 2? It is 15 by 200. Make it decimal. By cutting it 2, it is 100. It is 7.5. Then 0.075 is lambda by 2. Actually, the students are making number of mistakes in this question. They are finding only lambda. Actually, it is given you that to find the distance between conjugative crest and trough means lambda by 2. Next 3-mark question. A person produces sound with a siren near a cliff and heard the echo after 6 seconds. Find the distance of the siren if the velocity is 330 meters per second. It is very easy. Same manner, 2D is equal to VT. 2D is equal to VT. It is given as 6 seconds. Time is given and velocity is given 330 meters per second. So distance is equal to V into T by 2. Next important question. This question already I have discussed in just previously. 4 or 5 questions. Same diagram, same question, but data is separate. Just see, wave frequency is 100 hertz, frequency is 100 hertz, has produced in a string as shown in the figure. Find the amplitude, wavelength, velocity and nature. So amplitude is 5 centimeter, wavelength is 20 centimeter, then velocity. Velocity V is F lambda, means F is your 100 hertz into lambda. Lambda means 20 centimeter, means 20 by 100. Okay, 100 cut, it will be 20 meter per second. And its fourth bit is nature of the wave. Since the wave is produced in a string, it is a transverse wave. Okay, that means the particles vibrate perpendicular to the wave propagation. Come to 5-mark questions. Actually, in 5-mark questions, there are certain bits. Each bit either 1-mark or 2-mark, or in some cases a numerical means 2-mark or 3-mark. So same 1-mark, 2-mark, 3-mark questions I have discussed, you just learn them properly. Combiningly, they will come as 5-mark question. Here also I will discuss some pattern of 5-mark questions, you just carefully observe. First question, what is the reverberation? How is it reduced? Reverberation, you know the definition? A sound produced in a closed room persists no longer, it is audible. How is it reduced? By using sound absorbing material, curtains or false ceiling or making the plaster rough, etc. Next bit, if the velocity of the sound in air is 340 meter per second, velocity of the sound is 340 meter per second and wavelength lambda is 1 meter. Will it be audible? So first find frequency. F is equal to V by lambda is equal to 340 by 1 means 340 hertz. As it is between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, therefore it is audible. Next question, how does a sound wave propagate? Already I have discussed in case of a tuning fork, how it will form compression and rarefaction. Sound wave is a longitudinal wave in which particles vibrate in the same direction of wave propagation. Since it is a longitudinal wave, it transmits in the medium by forming compression and rarefaction. Then draw the diagram, the tuning fork, then compression and rarefaction, show it. What is the audible range of sound for the human being? It is between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Third bit, it is observed that some animals get disturbed before earthquake. Why? Because the animals which can hear the sound produced below 20 hertz, that is infrasound, squirrel, mouse, elephant, etc. They hear the sound produced below 20 hertz, that is infrasound. Next 5-mark question, why is the ceiling of the wall behind the stage of good conference hall or concrete hall made curved? Made curved means it is concave shape. At the focus of the concave shape, a person standing and addressing the person. That means the sound travel in all direction. In the front direction, it is audible to the person, and in the back direction in or other direction, it will travel and strike it and return back like this. Here the focus, the person is standing. Here the sound is moving like this. again the sound moved in this direction, it will move like this. In this direction, move like this. In this direction, move like this. That means always the sound will travel in a particular direction. Next bit, which property of sound lead to formation of echo? Briefly explain. Echo means reflection. Actually, sound travels, strikes any surface, means it will return back. That means the reflection of sound forms echo. What is the reverberation? What will happen if the reverberation time in a big hall is too long? How can we reduce it? Reverberation, you know that the multiple reflection takes place, persist no longer, it is audible. If it is a big hall, in case of reverberation, it will form echo. So prevent echo, we have to make the plaster rough, or we have to sealing it with false sealing, or we have to use curtain or cork in the wall. That means the sound absorbing material. Next question, the stone is dropped from the tower from a 500 meter high tower into a pond. What are the base of the tower? When the splash of sound heard at the top? This question is NCERT book question, NCERT exercise, question number 13. So this question carrying 3 mark. Another 2 mark question, how do sound wave cause vibration in the eardrum in human ear? This also you learn from the human ear part. Okay. Next 5 mark question, what are the characteristics of sound wave? That means characteristics of sound wave means loudness, pitch and quality or timbre. From each part, give one example with diagram. Its second bit, an echo is heard after 3 seconds. What is the distance of reflecting surface if the speed of sound is 342? This already I have discussed. What is sonar? Write its full form. It's okay? So these are all the 5 mark questions. So these are the all previous year questions from this chapter. Do better in the exam.